Casey here now with a look at things closer to home.
Yeah, a lot of severe thunderstorm activity generated by that system actually came ashore as a post-tropical system, after a short lifetime, and now the moisture is headed our way tomorrow. But getting a live look right now, we were talking about the Logan Square fountain being turned off for the season. But Joe, Cape May, your lights.
Yeah, what we've noticed about Cape May is that at some point this year, they start blinking yellow.
They start blinking yellow. That's the official end of the short season. We still got green and red going, but yeah, we had our first frost this morning across much of New Jersey. Temperatures dropping down to the freezing mark in some of our PA suburbs, and temperatures are cool right now. 52 degrees in Philadelphia, 46 in Allentown, some 30s already in the Poconos, down to 47 in AC, 55 degrees in Wildwood. Overnight tonight, not quite as cold, down to 47 degrees. That will be right around average for us. Mostly cloudy conditions, winds out of the southeast. They will be light. And for the day tomorrow, though, temperatures don't warm up all too much thanks to this easterly component to our wind flow. Winds a little breezy at times with periods of rain developing, and sunshine is going to be sparse throughout the day tomorrow. Storm Scan 3 showing us cloud cover already starting to increase in association with post-tropical cyclone Nestor. Here's that moisture already starting to build up into the Virginias. The system has moved away from Florida and really pulling now out of Georgia after making a landfall earlier in the day along the panhandle southwest of Tallahassee. So this is moving very quickly, and it will pass by offshore as we head into the day tomorrow. But we'll see some of that moisture wrapping around this low. So periods of rain developing heaviest along the coast. And for everyone, that cool, damp east wind is going to prevail throughout our Sunday. So not as nice of a day as what we had for today. Future precip showing us as we wake up tomorrow morning, might see some breaks in the cloud deck, but then that precipitation shield starting to lift in by midday. Now, this particular model, one of the most aggressive models as far as coverage is concerned, pushing the rain shield well up into the Poconos, others less so, but we are going to see the steadiest and heaviest of rainfall across South Jersey. Down the shore, we should see some pretty decent periods of rain in Philadelphia and some of our close PA suburbs. As we head into the evening hours, most of the rain concentrated along the Jersey coast, but the heaviest of rain in association with the system, thankfully, will stay offshore. As we head into tomorrow night, we're going to see things drawing on out and clearing on out. But as I mentioned, the more northwest you are, the less rain chances you're going to see throughout the day tomorrow. So in the Poconos, really not a bad day for a hike. Pack along the poncho, just a few passing showers, mostly cloudy conditions, and that foliage is peaking right now. Temperatures in Mount Pocono topping off in the low 50s. And then as we clear out tomorrow night, we'll make for better viewing conditions for the peak of the Orion's meteor shower. Averages about 20 meteors per hour. It is going to peak Monday night, early Tuesday morning. Best viewing in the pre-dawn hours. And the Orion's are known for their persistent tails. And as we head into Monday, we do have sunshine in store. Temperatures pop back up to 68 degrees. We're at 70 on Tuesday with showers again looking likely. And then nice, clear, and quiet conditions as we push towards midweek with high temperatures in the 60s.
Lauren, thank you so much.